Hello guys, and welcome back. Today we're going to paint the outside of a hull in the colors red and black. Definitely I'm not going to paint the gold right now because the red and black should be dry first. First of all, I have cleaned up my working area because I don't want any sawdust to lay on the wet paint. Also, I'm going to repaint this surface, and I'm going to make the some micro painting here that I have done when I started this model, if you remember, a lot of steps back. Before proceeding, let me tell you that first of all, I have skipped a couple of steps. One step is a little piece, a metal piece that goes here that will be done after the paint is dry. Probably I will need two coats, maybe for the black only one, but the red definitely two or three. Also, I have skipped a step here that I'm not going to do, not even after the painting, because this must be done after the varnishing of the deck. So, let me tell you a couple of things. I have marked what is the color. This is an R, I don't believe it's visible, but this is a B, also this is a B, this is black. So, this is an R, this surface, this here surface, all this, all over here, is going to be painted red. Also, the upper part of this rubbing strike. All the other surfaces, from this point here all the way to the stern, and all three levels are going to paint it black, and also the inside of the rubbing strake, the outside of the rubbing strake is of the rubbing strakes also here at the rail are going to be painted gold. But that's another thing. It's going to be done much later after all the paint is dry. Also, here, as you can see, this will paint it black, also the metallic pieces, also this will paint black, not this one, and these metallic pieces all the way are going to paint it black, and the outside is going to paint it gold like here. This piece is going to remain at its natural color, and I'm going to fix again these pieces that I should never painted them at the moment that I did. This is the time to paint. So guys, before applying paint, I will use some wood sealer. That's definitely the first step before applying paint, because like I told a lot of you again and in many videos, the wood has pores. So if I paint just without any undercoat, the wood sealer, then the paint will be absorbed by the wood. The result will be terrible, and also I'm going to need a lot of coats to make this look just with one or two coats. And one more thing, guys, I use gloss colors and gloss varnish because I like them. There are many reasons. I have made some reference in the past about what the reasons are, and I have fortunately not many, just some of my viewers that keeps telling me that the result is terrible. Let me answer that for those that are thinking of leaving a comment about the terrible result. It's terrible for them, not for me. I like it, and this model is something that I do, that I like, not what they want. Also, by telling me that the result is horrible or not good, and they don't like the gloss, it's like for me buying a car of a specific color, let's say black, and they do not like the black, and they say me that I should have buy a car in a red color, for example. So guys, when you think about leaving a comment for the gloss paint or varnish. Also tell me what the color of your car is, because probably I won't like it and you have to change it. So let me get ready and I'll get back to you to start painting the wood sealer. So guys, once more, wood sealer. This is going to be transparent once it's dry. It dries very fast until I finish the entire side of this hull and do the other. This part that I'm now applying wood sealer will be dry. So guys, let me do the other side as well and I'll get back to you. But before, let me just show you something. Allow me. As you can see here, the bee, and I'm not sure if it's visible enough. It's made by pencil and already it's begun to have a smudge. That's the reason that I do not use the pencil on the deck along the planking, because when I use the wood sealer, the whole everything it's going to be a big beautiful smudge. So let me do the other side and I'll get back to you to do the painting. Now let's paint the red first. Maybe I should change paintbrush and use a bigger one. Give me a moment. Let me do the other side as well and I'll get back to you to do the black. Let's paint the black. Remember, this is the first coat. Probably the black will need a second one. So I don't have to make any micro painting. That will be done when everything is ready. So guys, I have managed to fix the mistake I did. I'm going to use this to make some micro painting over to the edges and also to the gun ports. No need to film that. So let me paint the rest and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result. And first coat is done. As you can see, she looks absolutely amazing. And I haven't even painted the gold yet. Just black and red. I also did some micro painting on the gun ports. So all I have to do now is place the second layer, the second coat of paint, and of course the gold, and the other side as well is done. I believe this transformation is the second big one after the sanding of the hull. So the paints are gloss. If you don't like it, it's your right. Definitely it's your right. You can paint it whatever colors, matte, gloss, satin you wish. But if you're thinking about leaving a comment that the gloss is horrible or it looks destroyed, ugly and all that, please tell me what the color of your car is, because I probably won't like it. So thank you very much for watching, guys. See you soon with the next paint or step.